Hello and welcome to a presentation entitled Solving Simultaneous Linear First Order Differential Equations Using Laplace Transform. In this presentation, we're going to look at problems of this nature. In this case, we're given a system of two differential equations and we need to solve this using Laplace Transform. What we need to bring at this stage here, the fact that these are systems of equations. We need to bring our knowledge of solving systems of linear equations of this form. Let's say we've got coefficient a11x plus a12y equals to b1 and a21x plus a22y equals to b2, which is our usual system of simultaneous linear equations, is equation 1 and equation 2, because we've got two unknowns. So if we're given a system like this, this is a system of differential equations, and as you can see here, the unknowns in this system are functions x of t and the function y of t. So the structure is going to be to try to apply Laplace transform to this system and manipulate the system in such a way that we get to this type of system of equations, then we can use our knowledge of solving the system to solve to find the x of t and y of t. As you may see, there's no actually something new which we're going to do here, except that we're going to combine our previous experience of using Laplace transform in solving differential equations and our previous experience of solving linear equations. So what is the point of departure here? First of all, we know that if we're given a function of t, its Laplace transform is represented by f of s, and then the derivative, the Laplace transform of the derivative of that function will be s multiplied by the Laplace transform of the function minus the initial value. So we're going to apply this to this system of equation, which takes us to the following. Let's start first of all with the first equation. If we apply Laplace transform to the first equation, you'll see that applying this formula here to the first derivative, we get s multiplied by the Laplace transform of x minus 2, which is the initial value of the function x, and we'll do the same with y. And then when you get to 5x, we simply apply Laplace transform to x multiplied by 5. And similarly, we do the same with 3y. And on the right-hand side, we see that the Laplace transform is going to be 1 over s plus 1. So that's the transformation of the first equation. So this is going to be our equation 1. Then moving forward, now we need to apply Laplace transform to the second equation, which gives us the following. Then again, applying Laplace transform to the derivative here and multiplying by 2, we see that we've got a minus 2 here, but if we multiply by 2, then we're going to get 2s x of x minus 4. And then in the case of y, there's no change, we've got that. And then here we just put a placeholder for the Laplace transform, which is x of s plus y of s. And the right hand side is a constant, gives us 3 over s. So now we've got our equation 1 and equation 2. Now what follows is simple algebra to manipulate this system in such a way that it gives us our standard, the standard form of systems of simultaneous equation with two equations and two unknowns. And then we manipulate the system. What we should do, we should, on the left hand side, we should be left with x of s and the y of s as our known, and the rest should go on the left hand side as independent terms. And so that takes us to the following form of the equation. So if you group accordingly and do right calculations, you will see that you are going to have s plus 5 multiplied by that, and the s plus 3 multiplied by the Laplace form of y, and similarly in the next equation. So at this stage, we exactly have got our standard form of s, two equations, two simultaneous equations with two unknowns, which is a11 plus a12y equals to b1. and a21 x plus a22 y equals to b2. Now when you get to this stage with systems like this, we can actually use any method which you want. We can use Gauss elimination, Cramer's rule. But in this case, talk about Gauss elimination and Cramer's rule. You should understand that Cramer's rule actually is kind of a summary of what actually happens with Gauss elimination. So if you try to use Gauss elimination in this form, it's actually going to be too tedious to work with. So I recommend that you use Cramer's rule. So for us to use Cramer's rule, then we need to represent the system in the following manner. What I've just done here, I've transformed the system of equations into a matrix equation in the form AX equals to B. In this case, our knowns are in this column, which is x of s and x of y, and these are the coefficients of in the matrix of the coefficient A. And this is our right hand side column matrix. So then from there, we can now easily apply Cramer's rule, and this is what we should get. In this case, we know that Cramer's rule gives us x with its denominator, which is the determinant of the matrix of the coefficient, and in the numerator we'll get this type of a determinant. So we need to compute this, and I hope you compute this accurately. The denominator actually, if you multiply these two and subtract the product of these two, it actually gives us minus s squared minus s plus 2, and we can easily factorize that by taking out a common factor minus 1 and giving s squared plus s minus 2, and this factorizes as x plus 2 multiplied by s minus 1, and that will be our denominator here. But before we proceed, then we should also look at the expression for y of s using Cramer's rule. And for that, we get y of s in this form. I hope you recall Cramer's rule. As you can see, what has happened here, it's simple that these entries here, you have changed position, and what in this position here, we've got the coefficient of x, and the other side here we've got the coefficient of y. Then we need to compute now and find the expressions for x and y in the simplest form. Now at this stage, you can see that we are actually very close to getting to what we are used to. We've before dealt with finding inverse Laplace transform of expressions of x of s by using partial fractions. So we're close to that now. Then now that we've got the two Laplace transforms for our functions x of t and y of t, what we need now is to use the partial fractions to determine the inverse Laplace transform of these two transforms. In this case, what is all actually left with is simple to use our partial fractions and determine what is x of t and y of t. Just at that point, I would like to actually make you aware of that all these two Laplace transforms are proper fractions, because if you look at this one, the degree of the numerator is 3, but in the denominator we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, which is 3, 4. So you really don't need to use things like division to simplify. The same thing applies to x of s here. It's a proper fraction because the degree of the denominator is 3 and the numerator is 3. So you just simply need to go on, for example, for this one, just go on and say a over s plus b over s plus 2 plus c over s minus 1. And then go on and determine your unknowns a, b, and c, and then determine x of y. I'm actually not going to engage this now, because at this point we are actually at the point where we are dealing with what we have seen before, And then the challenges which are there are the usual ones which you are familiar with. My task was to show you how to apply Laplace transform from the beginning up to getting to these expressions which you are used to, and then from there you can carry on and determine your functions. What is important here, please double check my calculations. There could be some numerical errors somewhere, but if you really understand what's happening, it will be very easy to pick them, and then you continue and do your practice. The next thing, once you've done this and you've understood this, I should emphasize that I think it is important that you look at this example, try to understand it. Maybe try to repeat it yourself on your own without looking at the video. And then when you can do it and get the same answer accurately, then you can start your own practice. Before you can go to your text and do further practice, I invite you to do these following two simple examples, and you can see they're actually simpler than the example which we looked at above. So it should be easier for you to get the solution to this. At this point, I would like to say thank you for listening. My name is Chance Waswani Msipa.